In this lesson, I'm going to explain the Photoshop video workflow. Now, I've kind of alluded to the workflow already when I outlined what's covered in this course, but I'm going to go into it in more detail now. The first thing you do is that you bring assets into your project. And what's different about Photoshop versus typical video editing software is that when you add assets to the project, they go directly into the timeline. When you work with typical video editing software, when you import assets, they reside in kind of a holding pattern. In Premiere Pro, that's called the project panel. And then you put them in the timeline. But here they go directly to the timeline. And that's good and bad. The good thing is that they're right there in the timeline. That saves you a step. But the downside to that is that they typically go in the timeline in the wrong order. And sometimes they're layered one above the other, and you don't necessarily want them layered one above the other. But fixing that is no big deal, because the next step is that you arrange and rearrange clips in the timeline. And if they're layered where you don't want them to be layered, you can layer them someplace else or bring them down into one layer. So while that may be a little bit inconvenient, it ends up being fairly simple to fix it. Now the next step is to trim clips on the timeline. Now you know when you shoot video, there's lots of times stuff inside the video that you don't want the public to see. It's shaky camera moves or out of focus or things that people say that really are not important to the story. You just trim that stuff away. You can shorten clips from the end or the beginning, and that's a typical way that you trim things down. Let's say you also do something like a 10-minute interview. And all you want are, let's say, 2 15-second sound bites, two little clips out of that 10 minutes. You can then cut the clip in several places and remove the stuff you don't want. So trimming clips in the timeline is fairly straightforward. After that, you can change clip speed. You can have slow motion clips, fast motion clips. And it's important to do that at this point because when you change clip speed, you actually physically change how long they are. It makes the project longer or shorter. So it's good to get that out of the way at this point. Once that's all settled down, you can put transitions between video clips, and those transitions in Photoshop are very limited. They're only crossfades. That's when you fade from one clip to another. There are sort of variations on a theme. You can fade to white, fade to black, fade to a color, or do a typical crossfade, but you have only crossfades at your fingertips inside Photoshop. Going on from there, you can then add audio to the project. You can add a narration, add music, sound effects, and then you can adjust the audio. You can mix the audio, creating a nice blend. So let's say the narrator is talking at some point, then you can lower the volume of the music there to make sure that the music does not cover up or step on the narrator. You can place text and graphics on top of the clips, just as you layer things inside a Photoshop layers panel, you can layer them inside the timeline. You can put text above your clips. Let's say you can identify somebody in the clip or a location in the clip. You can add graphics like a logo or some kind of artwork, and they just reside above the clip for however long you want them to be there. You can apply Photoshop filters and layer styles to any clip, any text, any graphics that you put inside a project. And you can also put these clips in motion on the screen using some preset motion characteristics like zooming and panning. You can go beyond that and use keyframes to manually animate some effects in motion. So you can have things go exactly where you want them to go and have effects come on and go off exactly as you want them to come on and go off. Finally, when you're done with your project, you want people to be able to see it, right? So you need to export it. You need to, what's called, render it into a video file. And Photoshop offers up three different video formats that you can use to export your project. So that is the basic Photoshop video workflow.